How many of you have kids? Can I see a raise of hands? And any of your kids have ever been sick? Right? And you worry sick, right? And if you know that your kid has a sick, rare disease, would you go to the ends of the world to help your child? I met my first family with a rare disease a few years ago. I was finishing off my graduate work doing cancer research and then in pediatrics, seeing patients, where I met this little Indian family that has subsequently changed my life. This Indian boy came to us. They've been to some of the top experts already. At that time, I was at Johns Hopkins. They already went to Harvard and Mayo Clinic, and now traveled, drove all the way from Albany to Baltimore to try to figure out a cure and what's wrong with this little boy. This little boy grew up healthily, and around the ages of between sort of 3 and 4 started to decline, started unable to move his muscles, unable to talk, unable to feed. And by the time he came to us, around 6 years old, he was already in a wheelchair, and wheelchair bound. And no doctor has been able to figure out what was wrong with him. So the mom pleaded with us, can you try to figure out what he has? We said, of course, this is what we do. We will try, definitely. Halfway through the exam, the little boy started to whimper, like, The whimper became louder and louder. Before we knew it, he was shouting in pain at the top of his lungs. Our hearts broke. The mom started to be very worried, like, oh, don't cry, don't cry. I'm so sorry, apologizing to us. He's making such a fuss. Every time this does this at home, we don't know what to do. Can you help us? I'm so sorry. We just looked at the mom and said, we have no idea what you go through at home. We definitely will try our hardest to try to figure out what was wrong with your little boy and try to make things better. We spent the whole afternoon going through all the medical records, looking at all the previous charts, the pages and pages of things that previous doctors have done. But behind closed doors, talking to the physician, we realized that there was no additional testing that we could have done to help. So we walked out of that room and told the mom, and I still remember that mom's face when we said, I'm sorry, there's no additional clinical testing we can do. And I still remember them, their backs, the mom pushing the wheelchair down that hallway away from the exam room, and me thinking, there has to be something we can do about this. The thing is that the story is actually more common than you would think. In the U.S. alone, it's estimated between 25 and 30 million people are affected with rare diseases. So rare diseases are diseases that affect less than 200,000 people. But you say, wow, that's almost 1 in 10 Americans. How can this be so if they're rare? The thing is that there are over 7,000 of these rare diseases. So when you add them all up, they actually result in a large number of diseases. And because there's so many of them, it's very, very hard for government top-down programs to fund the research for all 7,000, especially if these diseases affect very few people and, you know, there are very few advocates for them. So it is then no surprise that of these diseases, only about 3% of them have therapy. Can you imagine that? 97% of these people with rare diseases have no therapy, and we're not even talking about cure. So this is a big problem, and it is not a problem, potentially, that can be solved from top down. What if we thought about a bottom-up method? What if we enabled the parents' love and energy of the 25 to 30 million parents to be able to contribute to research for their kids, give them the right tools, give them the right connections, the right scientists to be able to do that? Potentially, we can start solving this problem. So some of my friends and I, after I sort of came back from with this Indian boy, thought we had to do something. And with my sort of background in doing research in cancer and mapping cancer genomes, we thought there are ways that we can use knowledge and technology from common diseases as cancer to be able to help these kids with rare diseases. So a bunch of us gathered and says, we must do something. And we founded this nonprofit called the Rare Genomics Institute. And what it does is it equips and enables parents to be able to do research and advance understanding for their kids' rare diseases. So what does this look like? So meet one of our earliest children that we're trying to help. This is Robert. He's very, very cute. This is taken before he was 1 year old. He was born healthy, grew healthily. And after his first birthday, mom noticed that he was feeding a little bit less briskly, and then he was moving a little bit less. And before they knew it, over the course of 3 days, he was no longer moving. He was limp. They rushed him to the hospital and started doing tests, and doing tests, and doing tests. A year passed. 2 years passed. 14 years later, they still have not figured out what is wrong with Robert. Robert is still in his wheelchair, unable to speak, unable to move, and nobody can tell him what is wrong with Robert. But the thing about this is, we're in a time in human history that is very exciting, that people like Robert can be helped. The first thing is there's explosions in biotechnology. We not only map the genome, we can now do it for a lot more people. There's explosions in the internet. People are more connected than before. And furthermore, there's online philanthropy. So if we take these components together, we can actually create something that's really powerful. So how do we help Robert? The first thing we need to figure out is what's the best technology to help him. Around a little over 10 years ago, right, we mapped the human genome for the first time. It cost billions of dollars, international effort, multiple countries coming together to be able to map the genome for the first time. What's amazing now is 10 years later, there's a million-fold decrease in the price of genome mapping. So what used to cost billions of dollars, we can now do for thousands. And it is now possible for us to think about even mapping Robert's genome, just for Robert, a study just for him. This is a genome sequencing machine. We put his DNA in, we can put his parents' DNA in, and we can start looking at what genetically is wrong with Robert. But do you say, this is advanced technology. How can Robert access this? So then we need to recruit helpers. The second critical component then are the scientists. It's not easy for anybody off the street to knock on a door at a prestigious university and Mr. Researcher, can you help my child? So instead, we have gathered some top researchers from universities in the US and around the world at Harvard, at Yale, at Johns Hopkins, who've said that, you know what, if you bring us a child, we will help. We will help. So for Robert, we have teams of scientists at Johns Hopkins and Baylor College of Medicine who said, yes, if bring us Robert and we will help. So that's the second piece. The last piece is then, where does the money come from to sort of fund all this research? Since government funding is often more for common diseases and there's no specific funding for patients like Robert. So with the innovation of crowdfunding with websites like Kickstarter and Indiegogo, people are able to raise funds at incredible rates. We ourselves have built a platform where patients can come and create pages and raise funds for these projects for these children of rare diseases. And this is Robert's page. You notice he hit his goal of $7,700. You say, that's so little to be able to do for genome research, and that's what's amazing. This enables for us to map Robert's genome, his mom's genome, and his dad's genome to be able to look for what's wrong. And this was given from over 169 different people, friends, families, uncles, aunts, all gathering together, funding the state-of-the-art research for one single child. And now imagine, instead of Robert going from hospital to hospital, not being able to find an answer, we have a whole team of funders, whole team of researchers, whole team of people gathering, using the newest technology to be able to figure out and help Robert and to figure out what's wrong. And you know what's amazing? This haven't been able to share on other circumstances, but we found out what is wrong with Robert. Robert has a disease called dystonia 16, and he is one of less than a dozen cases in recorded history. So he could have seen all the experts in the world, and nobody could be able to figure out what was wrong. Now, not only did we find out that this is the disease that he had, we figured out that this disease actually affects Robert's muscles and not his intellect. So the whole time, the parents are saying, you know, we know Robert's there. Even though he can't talk, we know that he's there. But the doctor's like, oh, you know what? This is probably wishful thinking of parents. What has happened is like we now know that, no, Robert is there. And what is amazing now is using technologies with tracking of eyes, Robert is communicating for the first time with his family. And the funnest thing part about this is Robert has a really good sense of humor. He'll say, oh, that cat is dangerous. And then me touch, right? He's very mischievous. And right now, we're now working on new, you know, therapies now that could potentially help Robert, thinking about, you know, using adult stem cells, doing some simple drug screens. And we're so excited to partner with Robert's family to be able to understand this disease better, even more, and even more help Robert. Robert is one of many stories. I'll tell a couple for you just to end our time here. This is Maya, who's not only super cute, but we helped her find what was wrong with her, partnering with Yale University. And what's cool about her mom is a blogger, so we raised the money in one day. We sort of saw the money came in. And then we were able to figure out what was wrong. And she is the first patient with that disease. And they're studying it right now at Yale. This is David, and I'm excited to talk about David because we just found out that David's diagnosis 2 weeks ago. We've been walking with David for the last 2 years. We eventually sort of become Facebook friends with all these families. And the mom was so excited, you know, about David finally ending this diagnostic odyssey. Or even Joe King, which is a very, very sweet dad who works for his dad. His dad is a Chilean miner, and they had trouble raising the funds because, you know, Chile, they didn't have much resources. So his dad organized raffles and bingo contests. And I remember that email when dad wrote me, like, we raised the money and we're ready to do it. And right now, as we speak, we have an international team of scientists in Canada and in the US working for solutions for Joe King. And these are some of the other patients we're working for cures. For Windsor, we're trying to find out what's wrong. With Sabrina, and we're looking at answers for balance, and even answers for Aniston. And at Rare Genomics, we really will not stop until we're able to help find therapies and cures and diagnosis for the millions and millions of kids with rare diseases out there who are orphans, who are unable to find a home for their disease. At Rare Genomics, our belief is that when we gather the power of the love of parents, equip them with the right tools and technologies, gather around their communities around them, we'll be able to do some amazing things, grassroots from the bottom up. And we are really, really excited. Just imagine if the 20 to 30 million rare disease patient, a small sliver, 1,000, 10,000, the amount of research that we will be able to generate from the bottom up, solving diseases and finding cures. Because it's really our belief that there is no therapy or no cure. There's really no therapy or no cure that we can't find with the right technology, with the right tools, powered by the love of families. Because we believe that every disease deserves to be studied, no matter how few people affected, no matter how rare. Thank you very much.